People of Seven Hills Fellowship, it's Brian Pierce here. It's been a couple weeks since I gave the last weekly devotional. Krista and I got a chance to be out of town for about a week on vacation, the first time that we've been on vacation since the end of last September, so it was good for us to get away. We were in Santa Fe for a few days. We got to do some amazing hiking and see some beautiful scenery out there, as well as just get some time to be together. Anyway, so I'm back on today with the weekly devotional. And as you guys may remember, what I've been doing is I've been unpacking the story, the vision, mission, and values of Seven Hills Fellowship. This is typically what I do during one of our curious lunches after church. We usually do those curious meetings about four times a year. It's part of our membership process. And part of what we're doing as we give the vision, mission, and values is we're trying to communicate to people who are interested in Seven Hills. We're trying to let them know who we are and what we believe. And so over the last few weeks, I've been unpacking some of these things from our, again, our vision, mission, and values. In particular, I've been covering our values over the last few weeks. And we break up our values into two different categories, the what we do values and then the what we believe values. And it's just sort of a distinction of what we do versus what we believe, as the names clarify. Anyway, so the what we do values that we've covered so far have been restoration. And basically what we said is we're a community. Seven Hills is a community that seeks restoration, believing that God leads us not only to feel compassion for, but also to work towards the healing of a broken world. And so that's something that every healthy church should be involved in, is this idea of restoring the broken world. Then we talked about how one of our other values is reconciliation. And we said we're a community that offers the good news of reconciliation, believing that God desires and works towards drawing people into a relationship with Him. You look at 2 Corinthians 5, for example, verses 18 and 19, which say, "All this is from God, who reconciled us to Himself through Christ and gave us," that is Christians, "the ministry of reconciliation, that God was reconciling the world to Himself in Christ, not counting people's sins against them, and He has committed to us the message of reconciliation." In other words, part of what we're supposed to do as believers is we're supposed to share the gospel of reconciliation, how God desires people to enter into a relationship with Him. The third value that we talked about was education. And what we said is that we're a teaching community, believing that education should lead to transformation. Education should lead to transformation. I grew up in the PCA. The PCA, or Presbyterian Church in America, is a great denomination. But it's also a denomination that focuses very, very heavily on education. And sometimes some churches can focus on education, but that education doesn't always lead to transformation. And if that happens, you're nothing but a Pharisee. And we know how Jesus confronted the Pharisees in Scripture. So we believe that education should actually always lead to transformation. As our hearts are changed, we then ought to experience changed lives as well. Last week, or the last time I gave a weekly devotional, we talked about something that's also a value of ours, which is just friendship. And I know that sounds a little simplistic, but I think Scripture is very clear. And what we said is that we're a community devoted to fellowship or friendship, believing that God makes us fully human as we are in relationship with others. We believe that God makes us more fully human as we are in relationship with other people. And again, if you look at Jesus, Jesus spent 3 years with the disciples, and a lot of that time was in teaching. But He also spent a lot of that time going from point A to point B, spending time in relationship with the disciples and them being in relationship with one another. David Brooks has called this generation of Americans the loneliest generation ever. And part of what we see is that in that loneliness, in our isolation, we become less and less healthy. Our anxiety is on the rise. Depression is on the rise. We become less human as we're isolated. We become more fully human as we are in fellowship with God's people and, of course, with God's Word. Now, today's value that I'm going to talk about very briefly is relatively simple, but it's this, that we believe in worship. And what we say is that we are a worshiping community seeking to express our adoration of a holy and merciful God and to be formed by the gospel in the act of corporate and private worship. So let me read that one more time. We are a worshiping community seeking to express our adoration of a holy and merciful God and to be formed by the gospel in the act of corporate and private worship. There's a great quote by John Piper where he basically says that when Jesus comes back and we are living on the new heavens and the new earth, there'll be no more need for discipleship. There'll be no more need for evangelism. There'll be no more need for mercy and justice, but there will still be worship. And so unapologetically, we are a church that believes that we become more fully human as we worship God corporately, that is on Sunday mornings as we gather to worship, but also as we worship God privately. One of the things that I do every morning is I get up and I have my quiet time. I spend some time reading the Bible. I spend some time praying for various people in the group. And fundamentally what worship does is it shapes our palate. It shapes our desires. It shapes our thinking. And it shapes our lives, particularly as we surrender our head, our hearts, and our hands ultimately to God. Worship is the act of us basically saying, God, we believe that you are worth everything. We believe that you're the object in our all of the universe that is most worthy of praise. And I would argue that as we surrender to God in worship, that we become more fully human. We become the humans that God created us to be. And so unapologetically, we are a church. Seven Hills Fellowship is a church that believes very strongly that worship is what we are called to do. And that worship doesn't just end when this life ends on earth, but will continue as we spend eternity with God on the new heavens and the new earth. So I will come back to you guys again, hopefully next week with a weekly devotional. Next week, we should be jumping into our what we believe values as opposed to what we do values. In the meantime, let me invite you to either join us online for public worship at 10:15. You can do that via YouTube or Facebook. But also, obviously, we are now meeting in person at 10:15 on Sunday mornings in the DeSoto Theater. If you can simply go to the 7 at 7 or go to our website, then you can reserve your spot online so that you can attend in person on Sunday morning. We'd love to have you join us for worship. Thanks a lot. Love you guys. Have a great day.